my mind because I haven't got a brain. Only straw.
Well, how can you talk if you haven't got a brain?
Well, gosh, I don't know. I guess a whole lot of people do an awful lot of talking without a brain, don't they?
Well, I guess you're right. We haven't properly met yet, have we?
No, we haven't.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Very well, thank you.
Oh, I'm not very well at all. You see, it's very tedious being stuck up here all day long with a hole up your back.
Oh, dear, that must be terribly uncomfortable. Why can't you get down?
No, I'm stuck.
Well, let me try to help.
Oh, would you? That's very kind of you, very kind.
Oh, yeah, I don't quite see how to do this.
Well, of course, I don't know much about these things, but if you'll just bend the nail down and back, maybe
oh,
I can...
Yeah.
Whoa! Whoa! Oh, my gosh, there goes some of me again.
Oh, does it hurt you?
Oh, no, I just keep picking it up and putting it back in again. Oh, my, it feels good to be free. Woo. Oh, my gosh. Did I scare you?
Of course not. I just thought you hurt yourself.
You mean, but I didn't scare you?
No.
Oh, that's the trouble. I never scare anything. Crows come from miles around just to eat in my fields and laugh in my face, and all because I don't have a brain.
Well... What would you do with the brain if you did have one?
Why, if I had a brain, I could while away the hours, conferring with the flowers.
Help me go through the
might destroy you. Like that. Come on, Dorothy, let go!
Oh, no, no, no!
You heard him. Destroy us like that. Show her here, bro.
No good.
Emerald City. Everybody's very friendly here, and why shouldn't we be?
some of it right over there. And they took some of my lights out and threw them right here.
Oh, well, I guess it's you all over.
Oh, they sure knocked the stuffing out of you, didn't they?
Oh, well, you guys stop talking and put me back together. Come on, we gotta find Dorothy.
My dear, what an unexpected pleasure. How kind of you to visit me in my loneliness.
Oh, what have you done with my friends? Don't hurt them. hereby award you the Triple Cross. You are now a member of the official Legion of Courage.
Oh, shucks, folks, I'm speechless.
As for you, my galvanized friend, you want a heart. You don't know how lucky you are not to have one. Hearts will never be made practical until they can be made unbreakable.
But I still want one.
Back where I come from, we have men who do nothing all day but good deeds. They're called Philad, good deed doers. And the hearts are no better.
gotten my courage if it weren't for you, Dorothy.
Thank you.
thank you that you all deserve. Everyone in music, come on up. So I need to stop messing around. And stage hands, of course. Miss Gaynor. I'm not going to go through and hand out all the gifts, but I'm sure you all fall asleep. Now, also Mrs. Skowski and Susan Rickman-Dashi, the gift is about to meet. Kate Tover, who is our excellent, excellent stage director. Give it up for all of us who turned it off in the room tonight, Sarah. I know. I just like to say thank also the stage people, the lighting people. Technical director is only as good as the stage crew and the hands that help out. So we have some awards that we would like to give to some people, some very special people. There are certain people who this evening showed through their courage, their heart, and their fast thinking that they've earned their brains, their heart, and there's one that
courage.
Is courage, thank you.
Thanks a lot.
And also, sorry, Sean. And also who found their home here, okay? For the people who have earned their brains, I'd like to give a certificate of appreciation to Kate Tover. Cues at all, and they pulled off the show last night and this evening. So for their courage, Mick Bravo, Karen McCall, and Kevin Shaw. And a very special home award goes to our assistant director, Miss Jean Doyle, who was once student here at Morgan Park Academy who left to get her teaching degree and is now back home. Ms. Doyle? To the Munchkins, to the parents who helped, we say thank you very much and good night.